What will happen when you have 10,000 foreigners or 100,000 foreigners tribunals in this country, which is what will be needed if this process is extended to the whole country? What kind of process will be undertaken? What kind of people will be manning them? So if this process is extended to the whole country, as the Home Minister has been saying, that they intend to prepare an NRC for the whole country, what is likely to happen? So the first thing that we saw in this whole process that happened in Assam was that the burden of proof of proving that a person is a citizen was shifted on that person. And therefore, every person had to individually apply to be included in the NRC there. Those who didn't apply would have to be excluded. And not only that, they had to apply with documents, birth certificates, land records, school certificates, etc., etc. In a 1995 case called Lal Babu Hussein, in the context of registration in the electoral roll, where the Election Commission had issued a notification saying that if you want your name to be included in the electoral roll, you have to produce one of the following set of documents. Every piece of evidence which is relevant to proving his citizenship has to be taken into account, whether it is oral or documentary. That means if a person has no document of any kind, but if he produces 10 witnesses from his village saying that, look, I have seen this person living in my village for the last 50 years, and if that is enough to prove your citizenship, that should be taken as admissible evidence unless somebody displaces it. A large number of poor people in Assam as well as in the rest of the country do not have these documents. Educated middle class people also do not have birth certificates, etc. in this country. Many of them don't keep such documents. Many of them lose those documents. See, in the IMDT Act, the government had to accuse somebody of being a foreigner on the basis of some evidence and had to prove before the foreigners tribunal that this person is a foreigner. You don't just undertake this exercise where everybody applies to become a citizen. But this is a very easy method for the government to declare anybody to be a foreigner or a non-citizen. It just requires a stroke of pen of a corrupt or a communal officer who's sitting there at the beck and call of this Home Minister, who says that these are termites and we will eradicate them, etc. We have seen that when there are 100 foreigners tribunals, this is the manner of their functioning, that 2/3 of the orders are ex parte. This has become an easy handle for the government to put people at their mercy. This is what is at the bottom of all this. To disenfranchise, of course, the officials would be theirs. Many of them would be corrupt. Many of them will be communal. This government wants that maximum number of Muslims should be driven out of the National Register of Indian Citizens. In any case, people should be at their mercy to beg the government, to bribe the government, and to bribe the government officials for their names to be put on the NRC, etc. Lakhs of crores would have to be spent by the government to undertake this exercise, apart from the unimaginable human suffering that it will entail. But this is what the government wants, because above all, it wants a way to communalize the country. It wants a way to keep citizens at their mercy.